Hello friends. So to start this year off right, I've decided that I'm going to do more videos with my face in them. I just feel like it makes sense and it's a little more human and engaging. So that's how things are going to be going from now on. Thanks for watching. Let's get to the video. AirPods Max review. Okay, welcome to my very latest video. I say that not only because it is my latest, but also because it's my latest video and that it's late. You know what? I'm going to start listing shit off. Pairing experience. Easy. As long as you're using Apple products. Comfort level? 8 out of 10. As far as comfort goes, I've been wearing them on my ears for hours at a time now, and things seem to be very good. My only complaint is the memory foam seems to get a little warm at times. Uncomfortably so. On the note of wearing them, I have been wearing them around my neck as well, and I have to say that while I love flexing on the pores, they're just not that comfortable to have on when you're not actually wearing them on your ears. One thing that I discovered and which I really liked is that you can actually lift up one of the ear cups to quickly play or pause. The dial, or digital crown, as Apple is referring to it, is nice because you can turn it up or down very quickly, very easily. It also allows for fine adjustment, which is great. Okay, let's talk charging and battery life. I love that I can charge them while I use them. You can't do that with Bose headphones. Come to think of it, I don't think you can do it with any other wireless headphones. Also, the case kind of sucks. I mention it in conjunction with the headphones and charging mostly because when you put it into the case, obviously it turns off the headphones. And I just wanted to note that not doing this doesn't really drastically affect your headphones. You could feasibly throw away the case and burn it, or I don't know, chuck it off a cliff. The battery is more than sufficient to handle a couple of percentage worth of loss in this case. Also, the case doesn't fit properly. What the hell? Next, replaceable ear cups. This is actually a seriously underrated idea. I've seen some people with really gorgeous headphones where the cups are just shredded. The cups are a little overpriced though, obviously. Let's get to the best and worst feature, auto switching. For the uninitiated, auto-switching just means that your phone or your laptop knows that you're using your phone or your laptop and as a result knows when to connect your headphones to the right device, in theory. I love this because the software keeps improving and it's starting to feel really effortless. I don't even have to think about switching. It's like it's connected to all my devices at once, which obviously I know it isn't. But there's this really shitty thing. If auto-switching is enabled, you have to wait for your headphones to connect every time a TikTok, Snap, or a short video loads. To be clear, I'll scroll to a new video, the computer will then wait to figure out exactly which device it's supposed to be connected to, even though it's already connected to the device that I'm obviously using, and then once it's done that, it will play the video that I have scrolled to. This is deeply frustrating, and I know what you're thinking, Ben, close your laptop, and I would do that, but then my teacher would know that I wasn't in class. So you can see how Apple is at fault here. What's irksome is that the Bose 700s do this switching flawlessly. There's no comparison. In fact, I think that they actually are connected to two devices at once, and it's staggering to me that Apple has not figured this out yet. Regardless, regarding multi-device usage, the Bose 700s are just in a class of their own. They switch back and forth so easily. That is how much better they are.
Many hours later.
Also, it's worth noting that the irritating switching back and forth on the AirPods Max happens even after your laptop is closed, which is obviously really annoying. Now, the best solution that I've found for this is just to change the automatic connection to when last connected to this Mac. Yes, it kills some of the magic, but it also renders your headphones functional again. So, and just to be clear, when you do this, what's going to happen is your headphones will still automatically connect to whatever device they were last connected to, but they will not automatically switch back and forth depending on your usage, which in this case is a good thing because that was terrible and Apple needs to work it out. All in all, I have to say that I feel as much as I love this luxury premium experience, I think I'm more of an AirPods Pro man, mostly because of how much more vastly versatile they are. It's also worth noting that the AirPods Max are not waterproof or sweat resistant, which, I mean, for 800 smackaroos, come on Apple, I can almost guarantee they will be in the next gen. Lastly, let's talk price. These come in at over $800, which is a terrifying amount of money to spend on anything, let alone a pair of over-the-ear headphones. Don't get me wrong, they're wonderful, and I'd go so far as to say that the sound is somehow cleaner than the Bose 700s, but if you're multitasking or just trying to treat yourself without completely obliterating your budget, get the 700s, hands down. The AirPods are nicer in a couple of ways, but frankly, they just have some serious kinks that they need to work out, and they're not worth the extra money. Anyway, this has been BRBTG. Thank you for watching, and as always, I will be right back.
What's that? What? No, of course I'm in the shot. Don't be ridiculous.